Hello, my name is Martin and this is 3D Printing Iceland. In this video I'm going to review the PLA filament from IIO Robotics. This is a filament that Glenn at Funking 3D recommended to me, and I made an order of their 12 pack that consists of 0.5 kilo tools in 12 different colors. So let's have a look after the intro. Like I mentioned, this filament was ordered by me, AI Robotics Amazon web store. This review is only my own thoughts on the filament and my own money to buy this filament. Those filaments come in a 0.5 kilo spool, and the spools are really neat and look very good, and they have a nice system to tuck away the extra end when you're storing away the filament. It doesn't bend the filament so much as the normal two holes that you often see on the filament, and the spools look really nice. I was looking at their web store and they seem to offer only 0.5 kilo spools, and after receiving those 12 spools I would really like to have the option to buy a kilo in each spool, and I've been printing some things and was worried I would run out of the spool with a 0.5 kilo spool, but as having a 1 kilo option would be a nice addition to their web store. They also have some other filaments. The PLA at least is only in 0.5 kilo spools, so that's something they should maybe have a look at to get a 1 kilo spool. But the spool otherwise is working great, and I want to show you some prints I did. Before I show you the prints, this is the card that comes with the spool, and this is the color option in the 12 filament bundle. So it's basically a color spectrum of the rainbow, and the great colors. I mostly printed in the light blue filament, but I printed out maker crunch in all the filaments, so I will show you those. But the first print I did was this temperature tower, and as you can see it goes from 210 up to 170. I started to break off the sections just to find out where it was getting stronger and stronger. As you get into higher temperatures it usually gets a bit stronger by each step, but I was getting very good layer adhesion from 180 to 200, so I ended up printing at 200 degrees Celsius, and the print quality in all those temperatures were coming out great, and there was no issues. Even at the higher temperature the bridging was doing very well, and there was a tiny amount of stringing I noticed in the higher temperature, but otherwise it was looking very good. The next print I did was this stringing test or retraction test, and I noticed in the upper parts of those prints I was getting a little bit of stringing, and I have disabled C-hop on the printer profile, and without having that disabled I was getting more stringing issues, but that was an easy change in the profile to disable C-hop. And in the finer features I had a little bit stringing, but layer adhesion in those prints printed at 200 is pretty good, and it's pretty strong prints, so I was happy with 200 degrees even though I had a little bit of stringing in the topmost part of this print. And then printed out this test print, and here the overhangs came out absolutely perfect, and there was no issues in this test, and no drooping or no issues. And also the bridging here was really good, and I noticed a small amount of stringing, and that's basically the only complaint I could find. And then printed out this overhang test, and this goes up to 70 degrees, and the bottom side of it looks absolutely fine, and there's no issues even at 70, so it was working quite well for me, and very little deformation on the top part, tiny amount of drooping, otherwise it was looking very good. Here in the bridging test you can see there's a tiny amount of drooping on the longest bands, but other than that the bridging capability of this filament was very good. I didn't have any issues with bridging with this filament, and the surface finish on this print is very good. I then printed out this test. This is a part of the make tests, and this is just a surface test, and the dome part is looking absolutely beautiful, and you can see it's no issues in the dome, working quite well, and the globe here is also looking excellent. There's no issues this print, so it was looking very good, and the side of the prints are looking absolutely fine, and there's very smooth sides. Then it's this test I printed, and this also came out excellent, and this a thin wall print. The letters came out excellent, and no issues with this print, so I was getting very good results so far. I then printed out this negative space feature test, and all the pegs come out really easily, and it was no issues, so that went really smooth. And finally I printed out this tolerance test by MakersMuse, and in the 0.15 it was a little bit stuck, and I broke off the tab here But I used pliers to hold this down, and then I was able to turn it, and now it turns freely, so it was a little bit stuck in the beginning, and maybe I have to adjust the extrusion multiplier a little bit if I'm extruding a little bit too much. Other than that, all the other tests came out very loose, and 0.2 was also loose, so it was just this one, 0.15, that was stuck, but as I got it loose, it moves freely. And also tested out those brackets that I used to test out the strength. It's very difficult to break it. So it's very stiff, and also I already broke this. This was a test of the layer adhesion, and I was getting very good layer adhesion. It's quite difficult to break it apart. I was getting very good results, and especially on this one, this was really hard to break. Then printed out some more tests, and here's a Benchy I did, and this Benchy is looking absolutely perfect, absolutely no issues in this Benchy, and it was coming out excellent. As you can see, the layers are going down smoothly, and there's no issues in the sides. I'm going to see some issues here, but not on this filament. It was working extremely well for me. So this was looking awesome. Also the Omnom test, and this is modeled by Tessa, and this came out perfect, and there was no issues. I sometimes have some drooping issues at this location, but I didn't have that issue with this filament. It was coming out excellent, and the surface finish is really good, and here in the top there is no issues on the print, so it was looking extremely good. And here's the Otis model by Garrett at Chaos Cortec, and this also came out excellent, and there was a tiny amount of stringing here in between the hair things, but I removed those with a heat gun, so it was very easy to remove and not really an issue. Print came out excellent, and there's absolutely no issues with this print. I was quite happy to get this print look so good, and those three prints, the Omnom and the Benchy and the Otis model are looking awesome. I also printed out the Joelbot. As you can see here in the hand, there's a tiny amount of stringing, but other than that, it came out excellent and absolutely no issues with the print, and just a slight amount of stringing. You can see it here on the legs also. So that's maybe the only complaint I could find with this filament. It has a little bit of stringing issue, but it's very stiff and very strong filament from what I tested. Prints were coming out great, and the Joelbot is a very, very good print to test out filaments. It's a torture test in its way. Then printed out my Maker Coin, and here the Maker Coin was coming out excellent. The clarity of the letters is very good, and one of the best Maker Coins I've printed so far, I think. And it's very clear and absolutely no issues. And the backside also is very clean, and it's very good looking. And what I did with the Maker Coins, I printed out a Maker Coin with each color. Here are all the colors with this gel pack, and all prints came out excellent, and absolutely no issues with any of the prints. All the colors printed in the same settings, so they came out excellent, and I was really happy with this set of Maker Coins. So those were the prints I did with the AII Robotics PLA filament, and I got this 12 pack ordered on Amazon. I was watching Glenn at Funking 3D talking about this filament on his live stream, and made the order of this on a Sunday, and on Wednesday I had this filament in my hands, and I was really happy to get this filament because it was working quite well, and Glenn had talked fondly of this filament, and I had to test it out myself. Told in the unboxing video I would blame him or hold him responsible if this filament wouldn't work out, but it was working out very good for me, and I thank him for pointing this filament out, and it's good to see what other people are working with and what works for them. And Glenn also sent me his slicer profile for his MK2S printer, because he has that printer as well as I. So there was no issues tuning in this filament, just applying his settings and print all the things. To wrap this up, this filament comes in a half a kilo spool, and I made an order of a 12 pack with 12 different colors. It was a really good value on the Amazon web store to get this 12 pack, and spools come in a half a kilo spool. The only thing I could complain about this filament is they don't offer a kilo spool option, and there's a little bit of stringing, but the stringing issue is easily remedied by turning off C-hop and using a heat gun to remove the remaining strings. So it's not a huge issue. Strength wise, the filament is working quite well, and I love those color options they have. Maybe they will add more colors to create a 24 pack of 24 different colors. That would be nice to get, but for the price of this 12 pack, it is a very good value. I was quite happy to get a chance to review this filament. But so for now, I thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.